And gentlemen, welcome back to the Reich Strikes Back. We just wrapped up the 3v3. It is now time for the Star Wars-themed RTCW Cup going live here. We have Cave coming up versus Elite. Let's kick it over to our intro. We'll see you on the flip side. Very big thank you to Nail for putting this together for me. And he's got more to come. Epoxy and TK Powell, pay attention. Your names are in the intro. Oxygen Channel, good job today, sir. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show, guys. Welcome to Warwitch TV. Now to the classic 6v6 that you all know and love. We will have lost Sabo on camera because I'm not set up for him here. But you'll have me. We're back. Let's head over. Seamless transition. The Star Wars themed cup. Warwitch on the microphone. TK13031 with. We are switching gears. Time to get the lucky helmet back on camera. All right, here we're going to be taking a look at Cave versus Elite. With me on the microphone, though currently AFK, is Sabo the Saboteur. And also Merlin of One Soldier and Gut. Merlin, this should be a pretty tight game. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, I think it's going to be... this is going to be quite a deciding game as well. I think the winner of this game has the best chance of coming second in the group and going into the playoffs. Elite, of course, beating G-Men. They still have to play Unity, and I think they lost to Raw. So if they beat Cave and they beat Unity, they're definitely second in the group. Cave have already beaten G-Men, I think. I'm not 100% sure. But the thing with Cave is they had a game against Unity in week one, and I think that game was wildcarded by Unity, so that's going to be at the end of the group stage for them, so it's going to be a big rush of games for them. So I think this game is going to be probably the most important game for both teams and how the second place is going to be decided.
What week are we in for this?
Okay, so this is... I was waiting to cut in here with this, okay. But yeah, so in that group... The group one was the group that had five teams instead of four from the start. And so it, with that mixed in with a few match delays, it's actually been quite interesting for Cave so far, because Cave actually has only played one official match so far, and it was their week 3 match. So they started with week 3.
Okay.
Where they lost 4-0 to Rod. Now they are playing the Cave versus Elite is technically the week 2 match.
Okay.
So we will be on Frostbite and Base.
Okay, cool. A little more Frostbite. We all love that. Base. And then the tiebreaker, if needed. Dreaded Village. Dreaded Village. Welcome to, as we go back in time, as Huey Lewis might say, going back in time. Glad Sabo isn't here because he would cue up the song. Week 2 of the Reich Strikes Back Cup. Going live here in just a moment. How much time do we got, Merlin? 10 minutes? 10? 10-ish? 10?
Yep, I think around 10 minutes.
Okay, sweet. Let's do this. We'll head over here very quickly just to kill some time. Just to kill some time.
And I'm waiting to hear on server info here. It's been decided yet. We may actually play on two different servers as well.
I can't officially have pregame without playing Love Trousers. We've got Love Trousers to give away tonight. Love Trousers! This game I'm playing now is one of our giveaways here this evening. We might do two. Thinking of giving away the Jedi Knight collection as well from Star Wars. We'll see. See how awesome you guys are. Oh, sweet.
Did somebody say back in time?
You heard me.
You oh, devil. Yeah. Oh, man.
You devil.
I know. So, I'm back. What's happening?
Skadoosh. Just gearing up for our 6v6 game coming up here in a minute. Very excited that this will be our third of four. We're going to be doing four games. However, there'll be a long delay until our fourth game is going to happen at 10 p.m. Eastern, which is many moons from now.
Wow, that is quite late.
Yeah.
That one I will not be available for. I can tell you that for a fact.
Understood, Commander. I think Lasher will be here. I know I'll be here. Guts should be here.
I'll be here.
So we'll get it covered. It'll be the Birds versus Game Over, if I'm not mistaken.
The Birds!
Yeah, yep, they're back. Yep.
Am I still the unofficial team captain?
You are.
Oh, I completely forgot about that. Yeah, you haven't been on since then. Yes, you are. You've really been slacking in your duties, sir.
I know. I've been learning to fly an Uber, though. Does that count?
Yeah, there you go. Be the official team pilot and captain.
The official pilot. Hey, man, as soon as you buy a nice private jet, give me a call.
Let me go count my change jar later. Let's see where I'm at.
It's not the cost of buying the jets. It's the cost of keeping the jets and flying the jets. They only cost $30 million new.
Oh, really?
Only.
Yeah, can afford it then.
That reminds me of apartment shopping when I moved to Brooklyn. You know, we start looking around at places in a nice neighborhood in Brooklyn, New York. And this is, you know, I used to live in Memphis where everything's, you know, rent, everything's pretty cheap, pretty affordable. And they're showing me these tiny little one bedrooms. I'm like, well, you know, we'd like to buy if possible. And he's like, oh, let me show you this one. It's 400 square feet. Only $400,000.
Oh my God!
I'm like, oh,
is that all? Okay, yeah.
Oh, that's all.
Yeah. What?
What a deal! What an absolute. So we didn't buy, obviously.
Yeah, don't blame me. Oh my God. I guess the real estate market has recovered.
Yeah. Who knows? That might even have been with a depressed economy over there. It's just New York.
Yeah, I was gonna,
that's how it is.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't think New York ever got hit too bad, at least in the city.
Mm-hmm.
You know, cost of living in Murfreesboro is pretty cheap. I'm just saying.
Hey, Neil, what up,
Murfreesboro.
Sir?
Murfreesboro.
What up, my friend? We got the old crew back. We've got Neil. We've got Sabo. We've got Merlin. We've got Gut. I'm here. Oh, sweet. Sweet
good
mother
stuff.
Of God. We are set. The 18.
It is the 18. Nailman, I have not talked to you in ages. How have you been?
Oh, I've been good, man. Heard you were doing some training, learning how not to crash planes and stuff, like Warwick's
yeah.
on stream.
Yeah, I know. I'm a...
Don't fly
rest
like
assured,
me.
I'm a much.
Do not fly like
I'm
me.
A much better pilot than Warwick.
Look, look. There's a ship in the sea. Let me crash in.
Repeatedly, not just once. Let me just repeatedly crash into it. Like lessons not being learned
yeah.
here.
Yeah, I take off. I land. The number of takeoffs and landings are equal for me, which is generally a good thing.
That is very good. What do you think? What is your take?
Can you do a barrel roll?
Can you do a barrel roll?
I could.
Wait,
I have
I'm doing
before.
Shuttle Fox. Yes! Barrel roll.
Barrel rolls are fun, man.
All right, Merlin.
Go barrel roll.
Keep me updated on the game here. I know that we need to hop in server in just a bit. So if I'm getting close to game start, let me know.
Yeah.
Speaking of all things
also,
related to aircraft, actually, yeah. Sabo, just it's a
yeah
long and oh god, a long topic. But what is your take on the missing Malaysian flight? What happened?
Man, I knew you were gonna say that.
Yep.
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, to me, if you look at the flight track, it's flying along the coast on its typical route, and then it makes an immediate left turn directly towards the nearest land.
Okay.
Well, if I had some sort of really serious emergency, smoke in the cockpit or, you know, anything that critical comes to mind, that's what I'm doing. I'm going straight towards the nearest landmass and then trying to find the nearest airport. Could be smoke in the cockpit, could be some sort of a lithium ion battery fire that has happened before to many different airplanes and cars, apparently. So, yeah, I think there was just some sort of serious issue that went on.
Do you think they crashed?
They passed
out.
Or
do you think they landed and it's some kind of, like, controversy?
Now, I'm not saying I hope they crashed, but I really hope it's not some sort of controversy, because that scares the crap out of me to think that it's on the
like
ground in some mysterious hangar.
Like,
yeah, that's really scary stuff.
Like an
right
episode
there.
Of Lost.
And I would like to think that... Yeah, exactly. I would
that's
like to think
gonna
that
say,
that's not
it
the
is,
case.
It is Lost. They
Lost
crashed
life.
On the Lost Island. In there.
Yeah. It's
they're
mysterious.
The
it's
smoke monster.
It's mysterious. It's weird that they haven't found it, because there's lots of information, lots of tracking and stuff going on. So I don't know. It's strange. I'm getting tired of CNN, though. And they've
yeah.
gotten rid of... They got
Just
rid of the best
it the
people.
Missing Plane Network.
Yeah, there's a couple of people, like if you've been watching CNN, Les Aubin, who's a 777 captain for American, who actually lives in my town, flies out of my local airport, he's been great on there. They stopped having him on, though, because he makes sense. They come out with some cockamamie theory, and he goes, yeah, that's impossible. and then they had another guy, Rob Goyer, who's an editor for Flying Magazine. He's been great, and then they stopped having him on, so... I think they only want wild conspiracy theorists, which is kind of sad.
Yeah, it's been good for ratings. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Should we get this battle?
I'm pretty sure.
Who
I mean,
knows?
By, you know, if you...
I hope they find it.
Yeah, me too.
The most... I think the most obvious theory is it's at the bottom of the ocean somewhere, but I was going to leave that into... I was
yeah.
reading an article. I want to say it might have been Popular Mechanics or some... I don't know. Some publication did a study, and they were talking to people, and... And the best estimate of, we forget how vast the oceans are on this planet, but they were saying that if you could drain every ocean, just get rid of all the water,
yep.
that there would be, in today's value, about $60 billion worth of sunken treasure throughout the world.
Huh.
Wow.
Interesting. Which is insane to think about, $60 billion
yeah.
Yeah, in today's, what it would be worth today. I mean, everything
yeah,
that's probably
value.
Down there. That's their
that is crazy.
The best estimate.
Haley, I don't know. I didn't have a chance to check Facebook if there is a new Wolf trailer. I don't have it yet. I don't have it loaded into XSplit. There's nothing I can do. Also, Sable, we may as well disconnect here from Skype because
Skype.
I just don't. I don't have you plugged in for this command center. It's a
right.
different command center.
I'm going to lose the mic for just a second, so
okay.
I'll be back.
Thank you all for joining us here today. We're just moments away now from K versus Elite. The 6v6 action donations now made will go directly towards the Reich Strikes Back prize pool, which has been updated In fact, we'll take a look here at the moment. We'll head over to the page. And you can see it here. Make sure you follow at rtcwcup.com. And the
double
prizes are here. First place, Sabo. And this is all because of donations. 300 of my own money that I put in. 800 total for the first place team. Second, and they'll get 6 gaming mouse pads from Myo Electric, which is a very cool. Check them out on YouTube. Runner-up, second place team is going to earn a total of 350. And the winner's bracket, third place, a total of 230. The consolation bracket will receive 100. And that has been because of the support of the community. Amazing.
And yeah, the shout out again to Myo Electric there for the $100 donation and the 6 gaming mouse pads.
And the mouse pads.
All right, let's see. So where are we? As you guys know, I have been out of the loop, man, in training land for a long, long, long time. Reich Strikes Back. Which week are we in? What's going on?
We're bouncing around.
Who are the hot teams?
Yeah, we're kind of bouncing around. I think I was saying that when you were AFK there, though. So in the group one, it's played out kind of weird. I mean, they have a longer schedule anyway because they started off with 5 teams. And Cave, unfortunately, is kind of like their schedule's gone all over the place. They've only played 1 official match so far, which was their week 3 match. And now they are going to be playing the week 2 match against Elite.
Yeah.
They still haven't played their week 1 match versus Unity. I think Unity took a wild card on that one. So yeah, so this matchup is technically a week 2 match, but most everything else is kind of in week 3 right now.
Ice. Cave versus Elite over here. All right, so Elite's already played 2 games so far.
Yep.
I'm catching up.
I just got a Facebook update.
Oh, no, wait.
My wife
Elite's
supplies me.
Played 1 game.
My wife supplies me with Red Bull. And here's the update on my Facebook about it. It says, I almost got you the big 20-ounce can of Red Bull today, but I didn't want you to have a heart attack, so I got you the 12-ounce instead. Red Bull should be a sponsor. Indeed.
I agree.
It gives you wings. And heart attacks. Probably not the best, not the best slogan. Red Bull, we give you heart attacks.
That's not the best live read that Red Bull's ever got.
That was their first slogan, and they swapped that one out for it gives you wings.
Hey, speaking about Red Bull. Yeah. Speaking about Red Bull, they have reactivated the Red Bull Air Races, so apparently they'll be happening this year if they're not already. I was actually able to go to one of the Red Bull Air Races in New York. Absolutely amazing. That stuff is beyond cool. I don't care if you like airplanes or not, if you like any kind of racing whatsoever, that stuff is where it's at. It's a shame it's not bigger than it really is, because it's I think they do a really good job of kind of presenting it as a real solid sport, giving it that kind of like IndyCar kind of cool European sport edge. It's awesome stuff. We should shoutcast.
We should. Merlin, how close to game start? I'm putting up a straw poll right now.
I've just received server information, and it's in my comment.
Okay.
Cool.
If you guys would like to vote as to who is going to win tonight, vote now. I'm putting the link in channel. There is the straw poll link, and John and Sockdog and our other moderators will provide you with that throughout the shoutcast. Let's take a look here as the results begin to come in. Shark Punch in channel, welcome back, sir. Let's see who else is here today. Shadow Fox, still with us, that's awesome. Vasili. Victor. Lecter. Victor and Lecter. Eli Manning, I've not seen you forever. Where have you been, sir? Welcome back, thank you.
He's playing football.
Okay.
I saw Eli Manning when I was in New York. He was in the Wax Museum.
Really?
Madame Tussauds.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Cliff Arnold.
Down
here
on Times Square.
Cliff Arnold and Malman right where in channel.
Yeah, he was in the front window that you don't have to pay to get in.
Yeah. Yeah, I've never gone in, but I always look in the window because they They've got interesting stuff.
There is your link.
Sabo, you ever flown a Qantas boats. Air? You know, they're the only airline that's never crashed.
Never flown Qantas.
Qantas.
All right, server password information has been acquired. I'm going to...
Oh, they're not the only airline.
Head over.
It's never crashed.
Well, according to Dustin Hoffman, it is.
Oh, well. Yeah, because Dustin Hoffman's an expert on this stuff.
Well, he was in Rain.
He was in Rain Man.
Heading in server. We've just completed 3v3 matches. And now we are on our way. There we go. Say hello to everyone here in server, rocking my 501st tag. Really happy with how things have turned out here today. I think everything is nominal. It looks like everything is set and prepared. Merlin, we have the two 3v3s. We've got this. We have another game coming up later. So it's been just a very smooth day for Wolf. Some very solid donations. Some new faces in channel hitting follow as well. We haven't had any new followers here in a bit, so if you are lingering and you enjoy the show, hit that follow button, come back and see us.
And tell your friends, please.
Because we love to fly in at shows. Delta, don't ever leave the airport. Like Ford, found on road dead. Did you end up buying a Ford, Sabo? Did you end up buying a Ford? Yeah, I know you're looking for a new car.
No, I'm... I'm shopping, and I think I know what I'm going with, but it's a little fancy.
Okay.
It's a little fancy.
Mercedes.
Look at a BMW 3 Series.
Oh,
because it's German.
He's going to get a twin-turbo smart car.
No.
I lost my sound effects here.
Now, I did. At first, I was looking at the Prius, actually. I was like, this huge amount of fuel efficiency stuff. And I sat in the thing. I drove it. I did not like it. You know, there's something about the intangibles. And I just, for me... I didn't like the feel of the thing.
Hmm. Well, being in New York, you probably have a lot of places where you can charge up electric cars, too. So you can look at, like, a Leaf.
Dude, I'm in love
with... You
drive
past people, they wouldn't even hear you. You'd just be like...
I am in love with the Tesla. Like, the Tesla is, to me, like, the ultimate dream car. Yeah, they catch on fire and burn up, but hey, that's what insurance is for.
Okay.
those are awesome, but that's just crazy beyond my price range, you know?
By the way, Oba, thank you for re-enlisting. He's showing the way. He's showing how it's done. Really appreciate that. Welcome back, sir. Superboy. Hey, Warwitch, you released some cats from 2002 a while back. Any info where I could get those? I think they're offline again. I think I took them down because they were filling up my Dropbox or Nails Dropbox or wherever they were stored. Eventually, we'll make them available. Tons of them. Tons of RTCW from 2002. Tons of it. We'll head back in game. I need to step away. I really do. So let me hand this over to you guys. Sabo and Merlin are going to work on War Room coverage. I'm going to hopefully not knock my hat off this time. So Gut and Nail, proceed.
Good luck.
I'll be back in a moment.
Good luck to your hat, sir. Good luck to your hat.
Why don't we do a roster rundown? It's 1-on-6. It's going to be a pretty action-packed round here.
Hey, I don't
Islam's
know.
Got his work cut out for.
I'd put some money on Islam. He's a solid Panzer. I think he can hit some six-mans.
What's the straw poll say?
I don't know what the straw poll says, but I know what Games TV is saying, and it's overwhelming. Well, not overwhelming, but it's leaning in favor of Team Cave, and I would agree with that. Cave's a solid team. They've been around for a long, long time, and they've got rock stars like Homie, Islam, Pastor, Darky, Sanctity, Osiris, and Riva in their
it
lineup.
Looks like the straw poll is almost even. It's, so far, Elite has 15 votes, and Cave has 13, Zabo.
Wow, no kidding. Elite?
Yeah, so that's pretty close.
What are you thinking, man? I haven't been following this cup, because, as I said, I've been gone. Elite versus Cave, they're kind of on the same tier, skill level. We know Games TV is kind of leaning in favor of Cave. Looks like it's even on the straw poll. What's your pick? Who's winning this one? What's the point spread?
Well, Leech is winning on the straw poll, and they just got another vote, so they're extending their lead there. I don't know. I mean, Elite has names that we know as well. You've got Showtime. I believe he played with PMCG, Idlaw, Cliff Arn. It's people we've heard of. So, and I've played against a couple of them and just, you know, pub games and stuff. So I think it'll be really close.
All right, Gut. What do you think?
Yeah, is that there? I was going to ask. I couldn't remember which Cliff that was again. Is it Cliff Arn or Cliff Arn
or
Dark?
Cliff Dark.
I can't remember which one is on
the Cliff Dark. It's Dark.
We had a little spiel about that.
Oh, my bad.
Yeah.
We've been through that.
Warwitch did this last time. Yeah,
we've been through that.
But no, I think it'll be a really close match. I think you'll see a really good panzer battle between Islam and Idlaw. Two excellent panzers right there. I think Idlaw was a great addition for Elite, and it kind of raised them up a level. It's going to be tough. I mean, I would not be surprised to see this go to a decider.
Very quickly, I'm back in reading chat here. Superboy in channel. There actually is a Warwitch TV YouTube channel. It's pretty sparse at the moment. But if you guys want to head over and subscribe, feel free. There's really not much up yet. It's a project for the future. But you can find it, Warwitch TV on YouTube. Warwitch TV on Steam as well. And if you are interested in Titanfall, we do a lot of that now. You can find me on Origin as just Warwitch. Actually, no. Yes? No. Warwitch on Steam and the Warwitch TV on Origin. Okay. Just work the combination of throwing the TV in there and you'll find it. Thank you, Songdog. Appreciate that. Providing the link here in channel. Okay, so we are in server, clearly. We have Elite who are here. Idlaw, Showtime, H2O, Zelo, Mini, and Cliffdark. He's got the D at the end there to remind us of who he is. Versus Islam, Sanctity, and Osiris. The rest of the cave team should be filtering in here in just a bit. The maps tonight will be Frostbite and Base, right? Frostbite and Base? Which are two very different.
Yep.
Very different, very fun maps.
And Village would be the decider if Gut's correct.
Yep.
Of course it's Village. It's always Village. We can't go a week without seeing Village.
Keep in mind again that we have those game giveaways as promised. Somebody remind me. We're going to do game giveaways at the end of this match. And then we'll be off air for a bit, and then we'll be coming back in a few hours for the birds versus game over. So it has been a quad damage day of RTCW. Kith out there saying, incoming, decider, decider, decider. What's up, Sable? Sound good?
So, Merle, I don't know if you're there, if you can hear me.
Yep.
Hook me up with some war room information if you got it. We'll be able to crack the code on Cave and Elite and listen in on all their team communications.
Yeah, I'm asking the teams now.
Awesome.
I'll check in here, find out how long till games start.
We're still waiting on more members of Team Cave to come sneaking on into the server.
Oh, they're having server wars. Server wars are back. Oh, yes. Server wars. I remember this. It is the metagame within a metagame. So, I have another very chipper. We've had some very dark and serious music videos. We've had some Rammstein. We've been serious. Hell Hydra. But we're going to lighten the mood a little bit for you. So we're going to do a little intermission. We'll be back in a moment.
Thompson Twins?
No. I should have Devo in your honor. I didn't know. If I knew you would have been here today,
you should.
I would have loaded up a Devo video for you.
Oh, man. That Devo videos are insane. They're the best.
Oh, they are. So, Daft Punk, though. How's that sound? You like Daft Punk?